What is good, everybody? Welcome back to another My Damn Toys video. Today, we're going to be discussing something that I think I get asked this maybe once or twice. If you go back on all of my videos, guys, I literally get asked this question probably once a day. I'm not even joking with you. This is straight up factual information. Why do you not? This is the question. Why is there no women in the MDT Pick Fed? Why do you not include women in your Pick Fed? Create a women's division, MDT, where's the women, create a women's title, do the women, make women, all the women. You want women in the Pick Fed, and I promise you guys, I would love to include the women in the Pick Fed, but today I'm going to reveal to you, I know I've talked about it a little bit, but I'm going to expand on it a little bit here, and we're going to talk about why I don't include women's figures or women in my MDT Pick Fed, and why that they don't exist, why the women's division in MDT doesn't exist. And the reason I'm making this video, guys, is because I thought that my Elite Series 69 would be in yesterday, and I thought today would be the start of some reviews, but they didn't come in, did they? They didn't show up at my door. So now I'm going to create this video, and hopefully Elite Series 69 comes in today, and tomorrow or later this afternoon the reviews will start. We'll have to see about that. I'm going to try my best to get MDT Live up this weekend. I'm going to do my damnedest. I know I said last weekend, but you know, I got hit with some stuff, and we'll talk about that later. But anyways, let's jump into the video, guys. Why do I not include women in the MDT Pick Fed? Well, the first point, number one, is that the women's figures are really hard to pose around. They're very difficult to pose around, guys. Like, when I say they're very difficult to pose around, just take any regular male Elite figure. The men's figures are created way better. They have more stability. They can actually stand up. They have good knee joints. You know, their knee pads don't prevent them from completely standing. Like, I think the best women's figure ever made is the Ultimate Edition Ronda Rousey. And I love that figure. I can sit here and pose it around. I literally pick it up, pose it around all the time. And if every women's figure was made like the Ultimate Edition Ronda Rousey, you would see just five-star classics with these women's figures. I think that I would love to make a women's division and, you know, do my own take on women's wrestling and do some crazy stuff like that, like we do with the men's division on MDT. I would love to do that. And I would probably have two titles in the women's divisions, like maybe a Vindication champion, like a MDT women's champion, and then maybe like a cross-brand, like Extreme women's champion. And I would love to do that. I really would love to do that, but I cannot do it because, well, one of the reasons is because that the figure, and this is probably the biggest reason, is because the women's figures are so bad, guys. Like, I don't know if you guys own women's figures, you know how bad they are. I have a basic Natalya figure. It won't even stand up just sitting there. So I can't even imagine trying to make it walk down the ramp and get in the ring and do a suplex and do like a diving crossbody and all these different things. I think it would be absolutely just, it would literally hurt my brain to try and pose these women's figures around and get stuff going with the women's figures. Like, some women's figures are fine. Like, I think the Lita figure is pretty solid. The Asuka, the Elite Asuka. Some of the Sasha Banks figures are good. The Ember Moon's good. But most of the figures, like, I don't want to have a division with just four girls, you know, like, or four women or whatever. I can't build a division around four women. You need at least 12 women to build a division around. You know, you have your contenders, you have your extreme, whatever, you know, the case would be. I've thought about bringing in women to MDT in a manager role. I think the only woman that we've ever seen on MDT television is Maurice with The Miz, and the reason that she has stopped appearing on MDT television, everybody just kind of saw her disappear off the face of the planet. The reason that happened is because Brad couldn't pose her around anymore, and once he got rid of her and I started filming Vindication myself and, you know, taking over full responsibility for all of the posing and the shows, then that is when I just never brought her back. And then Miz hasn't been on TV, so that's another reason she hasn't been seen. And plus, she has those high heels, guys. She was a nightmare to pose around. I know she wasn't included much, but just doing Miz's entrance with Maurice's figure was absolutely atrocious. It was a super duper headache. It was very frustrating. And again, I would love to include the women. Like I said, the Ronda Rousey figure, I mean, there is a possibility that we may see a women's division in the future. I'm not going to say it's totally impossible or totally, you know, off the wall that it couldn't happen, but as of now, they just don't make the women's figures good enough, and I think that it would require a lot of customization. It would require, you know, a lot of work just to even create the women's division. And maybe I can muster up something. Maybe we may have one women's match at My Damn Nation. Who knows what the cards hold? Who knows what the booking in the future is going to hold for that card? But maybe we'll have the first women's match ever at My Damn Nation. That would be pretty cool to see. I'm not going to say that it's a definite, and then it's definitely going to be happening, but it is something that I've thought about and that I've played around with in the, you know, in the creative board meetings with Brad. And so, yeah, man, I really would love to include him. It's mainly like the ankles and then like the legs. Like the legs and the ankles just do not want to pose. And then you got to think the arms are single jointed just like the men, so the arms aren't a big deal. They don't have a good ab crunch. But the main deal is that they can't even stand up. Like they want to fall. Their legs get really loose. Like this Natalya figure, it's probably my least favorite figure in my collection, guys. Because every time I do a predictions video or a recap video or a review results video for you guys talking about shows and stuff, I take the Natalya figure. If she's on the show, I try to set it up and try to, you know, talk about it and everything. But she wants to fall over. She wants to face plant. I think one women figure falls off of my shelf daily. I'm not even lying to you. Like yesterday, my wife, face wife, was in here editing pictures on the computer, and Charlotte just took a tumble and fell on top of her. It's just what happens, man. The figures aren't good, and I really hate it. And another crappy figure is the Bayley Network Spotlight. The ankle joints, her feet are tiny, and she just wants to fall over, man. It sucks. I think the Shayna Baszler's a good figure. The Trish figures are good. But that Ronda Rousey, if everyone woman was made like a Ronda Rousey, or even just the quality of the Oscars or the Sasha Bankses, I think it would be possible, but it's not. They don't make enough good women's figures to create an entire division around, and maybe that'll change in the future. Maybe we'll get another Ultimate Edition or something, or I don't know. Man, I'm definitely playing around with the idea of including a women's match at My Damn Nation, but I don't see it happening at the moment, but we will see what happens further down the line. But that pretty much is it for today's video, guys. I wanted to answer that question, and I also didn't have anything to put up today because of the Elite Series 69 not arriving yet. I don't even know if it's going to be here today, but maybe I'll get some other stuff in here and we can talk about it and everything like that. We do have Extreme Rules on Sunday that I'm looking forward to, and I am filming the Pick Fed, so MDT Live should be up soon. But please let me know down in the comment section below, guys. I would love to know your thoughts on everything. Why, you know, what do you think? I would love to know everything down in the comment section below, your response to me. You know, do you agree with me? Do you think they could improve the women's figures? I think they could drastically improve them. I think that is what's preventing, you know, ultimately that is what is preventing an MDT women's pick fed division. So let me know what your thoughts are down in the comment section below, and I would love to hear your thoughts, guys. Thank you so much for watching. That is going to do it for today's video. Subscribe to the channel for more epic WWE figure videos. Follow me on Instagram and Twitter at MyDamnToys, and I will see you guys in the next video. Thank you.